So hi again. We'll start in this video exercise 5.9. So page 56 in the book. So we are asked to write a program that converts a temperature from Fahrenheit to Celsius. So we need to use the following formula. It's 5 over 9, the degree in Fahrenheit minus 32. So usually the degree in Celsius contains comma, so it's a real number. And if we look closely to the operation, so we have 5, 9, F, and 32. So all these four values are integers, and we have a division, so we need to pay an extra attention to that. So the user should enter the degree in Fahrenheit. So print F, enter the degree in Fahrenheit, and we'll scan F using percentage D and let's say address of F. So I need to calculate the degree in Celsius. So the degree in Celsius should be a real one, so it could be a double float or a long double. So C would be equal to 5 over it's equal to 5 over 9 multiple F minus 32. So if I print the value, it would be wrong. So let's check the value percentage. So temperature, let's see, let's write percentage D C is equal percentage F backslash n. So the first percentage D is for the Fahrenheit, so this one is wrong, so Fahrenheit here, and we have the degree in C here. So let's run this program. We will see that again we will have a wrong answer. So let's put 200. So we'll end up with also a zero. So why we will end up with a zero? So let's evaluate step by step this expression. So first we will evaluate what's between the parentheses, the brackets. So f, which is an integer minus a double one, it would be a double. However, we have an operation like this. It's 5 over 9 multiple a number which is of type double. So first, since we have just multiplication and a division, so the evaluation will start from the left to the right. So first we will do 5 over 9. So 5 over 9 integer over an integer, so the answer would also be a zero. So in order to remedy to this problem, we cannot just write this, so we can even remove this one and force one of the first two numbers, 5 or 9, to be of type double. So let's rerun it again and check that it will work now. So 200 Fahrenheit is equal to 93.3 degree Celsius. So here's a tricky problem. So just to make sure that you know well how the order of the operators works, and in order to have a correct answer. So this is done for this exercise. If you have any questions, do not hesitate to ask, and do not forget to subscribe to this channel and to hit the bell icon to turn on notification, and do not forget to check the link of this exercise in the description below to see the solution on the website.